Hello there, my name is Tom Camp, and I'm here today to talk to you about Ably's new product, Spaces. We'll talk a bit about what Spaces are, why they're useful, and then finally go into a bit of a code example and demo to demonstrate how you can get started with it. So, what is Spaces? Spaces is the new Ably product available via a JavaScript SDK, which makes it easy to create collaborative spaces and environments for your end users. So, for example, in the Spaces landing page, you can see a number of examples of collaborative experiences that you can bring to your users, such as the avatar stack, live cursors, and elements you can interact with and be shared between all users of that space. Likewise, having lockable elements which allow for you to see who is interacting with a specific element and also stop others from interacting with that element. Collaborative experiences and environments are becoming more expected by end users and give this sense of a live space and a live environment which help make it more interactive and more enjoyable to use, and is often seen as quite integral to any form of collaborative document or editing or workshopping where you expect to have multiple users actively working together in a shared online space. So let's actually look into an example, where on the right here you can see two browser pages with what will be an avatar stack. At the moment though, there is only one representation of each user in each of these places. So what we need to do is allow for these browsers to communicate with one another in a scalable way. And this is where the Spaces SDK comes in, where on the left you can see that we are going to firstly instantiate the basic Ably client library, which allows for us to establish a connection to the Ably servers. After that, we can use that connection to instantiate the Spaces instance, which means that now, with that Spaces instance instantiated, we are able to then try and get one of the spaces that we wish to inhabit and make use of. In this case, one by the name of My Live Avatar Stack, which will be the name of the space these web pages will make use of. With that space, we can finally enter it with a name and a color, which will be used to represent our name and color as we appear to other users. And finally, we can listen in by subscribing to the members of the space. And each time something changes within this members, be it a change of color, a change of name, or entering and leaving, that will evoke an event, which then we handle by updating the state of all of our avatar stacks. So if we save that, and then refresh the pages, you can see that we now have both members represented. And likewise, if we just add a couple more people in, you can see they each get added, have the correct color and name representing each of them in each of the different spaces. This would just be one component of a collaborative environment where you'd have, let's say, the avatar stack indicating who is there, as well as also live cursors being shared between all users and editable text elements and adjustable icons and all of the things you'd expect in any form of editing software that can be edited by multiple people at once. In the description for this video, you'll find documentation as well as blog posts detailing in greater detail than this video about how you can get started making use of this SDK, as well as also we'll be releasing more videos on this channel which will be expanding on some of these use cases and giving more in-depth information on specific use cases. Thanks a lot for listening and have a great day.